opportunities you can reach all the way down. If you're lucky to meet the right people to give you your first breath. And it always takes a little bit more. Sometimes it's really difficult and very hard to find exactly what you are looking for. Find it. But if you want to achieve it, you have to pull one out of the bag. Rescued him about 6 years ago at a birthday party. The dad was like, the kids aren't looking after the guinea pig. And I went out and he was covered, his cage was covered in cobwebs. He was really scared. And gave him a new chance at life. And he's had lots of fun shows. And this is Frankie. It's beautiful. All right. Enough of this inspirational stuff. Let's have some fun. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I do have something really, really cool to show you. I hope you like it. You know, I love the cover. I'm a big Star Wars fan, but you don't need necessarily need this very nice handle. Can you take that out? Is that okay? Come out. Does that not come out easily? Yeah. I'll show you a new way to protect your phone. I discovered this to make the phone, it's like nearly 100%. It's really good. Okay. Basically, I'm going to hit your phone 3 times and then restore your phone back to its original condition. This guy's videoing this, he's like, that could have been my phone. It's funny because if it was your phone, you wouldn't be able to do it. Okay. I should probably also put on some protective glasses. I think I should have some here. No, I don't have it. It's okay. We'll just work like this. Okay, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. The most important thing is to believe. Okay, are you ready? Are you guys ready? Over here? Yes, yes. Yeah. Most important other thing to remember is if you see this hammer flying towards you, make sure you catch it. It's not a real hammer, it's okay. You can just scroll back. That was the other part of the act, is the vanishing. That's
why we don't appropriate kind of
thing. Hi, yes, ma'am. Oh, thank you. US. It's pretty cool. Here we go. There is your phone back. Hold your phone in the other hand and concentrate. You'll start to feel them jump from one hand to the other. One, two, three. Did you feel anything?
No.
Not just yet. Okay, it will happen in a second. One, two, three. Did you feel anything? Try one more time. Maybe stand up for a second. Turn around for a second. Sorry, champ. What's your name?
Reese.
Okay, concentrate. One, two, three. You'll feel them jump from one hand to the other. One, two, three. Let me see. That trick never works. Okay, take a seat. Ladies and gentlemen, being a teacher of magic, sometimes I get young magicians come into my magic school, and some of the things they tell me are pretty funny. Sometimes you have to just listen to their story, and sometimes you just think, wow, that's pretty interesting. For some reason, a lot of magicians that are here in the audience will know this is true. I don't know if it's in magic books or something like that, but you always get like 5 or 6 year olds, or even 7 or 8 year olds, when they do a magic show, and it always starts off like this. On my recent trip to India,
Yes?
Yeah. It's not. Come on. It's okay. It's Okay, are you ready? I'm going to get you, please, to lift the weight. Yes, please. And then I will pull the silk away. Okay, are you ready? Okay, I'll move it over here. Okay. Yeah, just the lid. Yeah. You ready?
Yeah.
It's okay. He's asleep. Okay, yeah, that's good. Okay, would you like to pull the silk away? No, I'll do it. Okay.
He's in a coma.
Okay. Is that your card?
Yeah.
It is. Let's hear it. Right.
Thank you very much. Thanks for your help.
All right. There you go. Awesome. We're just going to finish off with one last little bit of magic. It goes back to that first magic trick that I showed you earlier on. As a magician, I often wish I could read minds, you know, sort of wish I could find out what my audience think, if they like what they saw or all that kind of thing. Would you be able to help me? And here I have four cards, okay? They're the four queens. Pick a colour, red or black? Black. So I'll take out the red ones. This is the red queen of diamonds. Could you please hold on to that for me? Thank you very much. Excellent. And this one is the red queen of hearts. If you could hold on to that, excellent. Excellent. Try not to bend your cards. Thank you. That should leave me with two more cards left in the pack. Queen of spades and the queen of clubs. Which one would you like me to take out? Take out the spades. Okay, so could you please hold on to that young man? Thank you very much. Excellent. And very nice. And that will leave me with one card left, ladies and gentlemen. I'll turn that card face up. It's the queen of clubs. There it is. You will not believe this, what is your name? Emily, there is one card that is face up here. The Queen of Clubs. You know what you're looking for. Let your dreams fly. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready?